Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great week, folks. Always do your best, but don't overdo. When you overdo, you deplete your body and you go against yourself, and it will take you longer to accomplish your goal. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 18, NASDAQ off 2, S&P's down 4. Bottom line, folks, you get a sideways market. You get holiday trading out here. You get Columbus Day, bank holiday, not a stock holiday, bank holiday, though. A lot of traders are just staying home. Gold contract up $7, traded at $14.95 an ounce. We got silver up 12 cents, $17.67 an ounce. Light sweet crude, traded 7 taken off there. That's down $1.34, trading $53.36 a barrel. And that looks like it wants to get into that $50 level. Once again, it's been in this consolidation for a long period of time. Bottom line, it's going to go after it. We have the bond market closed out here today. King dollar. King dollar up 171.6 ticks, trading 98.478. The euro is at 110. The yen is at 108. And the pound is at 125 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, Friday, you had a nice up day. That being said, this market gave it up in spades coming into the close the last 20 minutes of Friday. We pull this back. What you're going to see out here, you went right back to the beginning of the day. You know, we started out the day in the SPY at $296.25. You got all the way up to 298, and then at 3:40 p.m., we went from 298.64 down to 295.58. Gave it up monster volume there. Bottom line, we expect we're going to see coming into tomorrow is that you're going to see the SPY down at the 293 area, because what you have is this. We came down, you had a flat market all day. That being said, you're into the gap already. The gap from Thursday to Friday went like this. Thursday, we closed at 293.29. You woke up Friday, and you were at 296.27. And we're right in that gap right now. So I expect that little baby is going to get filled. NDX 100, same setup in the NDX. When they were selling the market, they sold it right across all the indices on Friday afternoon. So what we had out here is this. On the Qs, same type of setup. Bottom line, it opened up at 190.80. They get all the way up to 192.29, and then they close out at 190.67. Same type of setup. That gap is wide open, meaning at that 188.83. Gold contract. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract, they took that thing south at 10:40 in the morning. That being said, guess what? They couldn't get it to the swing point, number one. Volume was light as to what it's going into, and it rejected lower price. So bottom line, what you have out here, we got down a price point of 1478. You had volume of 486,000. You were going against 652. Rejected lower price, had tremendously lighter volume. This thing still wants to go up to its highs. The highs that we're talking about right here is 1566. Oil contract out here. So what do we have with oil? Oil contract right now, trading at a price point of $53.36. That's down $1.33. What we have out here is that you get 440,000 contracts. Now, what you have out here is that's big contract volume for basically like a half a holiday out here. We'll see how this shakes out. It hasn't been able to hold price, but it looks to me like we're building cars to get into this $50.48, which is the lower end of this consolidation that we've been trading in since June. King dollar. What do we have with King dollar? So King dollar finally had some price movement last Thursday and Friday. We had King dollar go from a price point Thursday of 99.06 down to 98.19. It's peeking its head up again. Anything under 98.371, which we're 120 ticks above right now, will set up a run down to the 95.843. And that's the lower end of this consolidation. And what did it on Friday, as well as Thursday, was the pound. The pound came off its lows. This is the second sign of strength, by the way, also, that the pound had. This is kind of like a classic. It's without volume because we don't have volume on the currencies. But what you're going to see here is that the pound made a low on the night on the 3rd of September, 119.51. Blast off out of that low and goes to 125. Pulls back right into the huge sign of strength that we had on September 4th, rejected it, and then took off like a rocket ship again. Bottom line, this pound is looking to get up to this 131. That's on the daily. On the weekly, it looks to me like it's a 136, I believe. Let me see this number. No, 133. 133, and you're at 125 right now. And if you do take a look at this, what you're going to see is that if we set this trend up, you're going to see that, and this is, I always love these, you're going to see that the first movement higher September 6th off its low did break the trend. The downtrend that had been, well, the downtrend had been in place for a long period of time. I'm just talking about the small one from the 15th of March. Then you backed right down into the trend line, rejected it, went topside again. That's bringing the probability much higher that we are going to get up to this 133.81 area. Some of the higher volume stocks out here. Actually, let's talk about WeWork. WeWork, folks, this just doesn't stop with WeWork. They just shut down. They just had a shut down 2,600, I think, 2,300 phone booths that they have inside of their companies. If you haven't seen these things, I don't know exactly what theirs look like, but I've been in a couple of these open spaces. They look like little astronaut places. Like they're about 10 feet long. They're tall. You go in there, you make a phone call, or you just have a meeting inside the place. Well, the bottom line is that these happen to have formaldehyde inside them by the manufacturer. And with just one on top of the other, meaning trouble-wise for this company, because that's some serious business. Most of the places, that's big money, too. There's no two ways about that. So, you know, we'll see where the rest of this goes. What you also have, what we work out here this morning, today in general, is that you have SoftBank is trying to figure out a way that they may be able to basically come in with more money and then take a controlling interest, doubling, tripling down. Pretty heavy, actually. Stay right there, folks. Going to be coming back with our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes. We are going to be talking markets. Dow Industrials right now trading. Where is it? Trading down 26. NASDAQ is flat. S&P's down 3. We'll come right back.